بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Our part 2 of the lecture of the breast discharge. We will see some of the cases also. Here we have a dilated duct, and this duct is caused by hypo to isoechoic lesion. And there is multiple calcifications seen. But by vascularity, there is marked increased vascularity, not lacking arborization, malignant vascularity. And there is extension outside the duct also. So this is with malignant nature. This is another case. Here we have dilated duct. And this dilated duct show a ball-like lesion. It's not attached to the wall. And here, this is the dilated duct. So first we could think that this is an echogenic secretions. But you have to trace the duct all through. On tracing the duct, there is another lesion here. This is the secretion we said about, but here there is a mass causing focal dilatation of the duct with microcalcifications, and there is the vascularity present inside. Here there is no vascularity, but in the larger mass there is vascularity inside. This is the large mass showing vascularity inside. This is the mass showing high vascularity with lack of arborization, but here this is the incipitated material, so this is not like that. Here when you put Doppler, you have to see that there is blood flow in the parenchyma of the breast. So when you find blood flow in the parenchyma of the breast while in the lesion inside the duct there is no flow, so this is with secretions. But in the presence of flow, even if minimal, so this is with intraductal solid mass. This is a case, 30 years old, with left brownish discharge and uniorificial bleeding. The mammo is not non-specific. There is no definite lesions seen, so it's pyrate zero. On ultrasound, we have here intraductal masses, not only mass. This is the duct, and this is means that it is intraductal, that the duct is splayed on that mass. But there is another one and another one. So this is the appearance of intraductal papillomas. This is one papilloma, second papilloma, and third papilloma. But we didn't write in our report papilloma. We write that there is intraductal masses, likely penile looking, but still we give them pyrates for biopsy, because any intraductal mass we must biopsy. So this is in multiple intraductal papillomas. This is another case, 61 years, left with yellowish breast discharge for 1 year, and she felt a small lump. And here the mammogram show a lobulated a mass, isodense mass with lobulated outline, and the tubular structure seen here also. So here the mammogram, we can put it pyrate 3-4 assessment. Apart from this tentacle seen, this tentacle make us to raise the pyrates. We may put it pyrates 4 until we do ultrasound. That was her ultrasound. There is a mass, and this is this mass is extending to the duct, and this which make the tail-like appearance on mammogram. And this is the dilated duct, so it appears on mammogram as macrolobulated, well circumscribed, and there is a mass inside here, and this mass is vascular, and it was intraductal carcinoma. This is, note here the ductal dilatation is very much more proximal to the mass. This is the mass and the mass extending to the duct. So this is ductal dilatation with a mass seen inside the duct with irregular outline, show microcalcification and show vascularity. So this is intraductal invasive carcinoma. Another case, 35 years with left uriorificial serous anginous nipple discharge. And this is galactography showing the duct with irregular outline, but we couldn't find filling defects present in that duct. And here we have the duct showing, this is the typical appearance of incipitated secretions, bowl-like, echogenic, not dependent, and not attached to the wall. So this is echogenic incipitated material. How to be sure that this is incipitated secretions? You can ask for, you can put it pyrethroid 3 for close follow-up. You can make the patient squeeze her breast. These incipitated secretions will change in position and appearance. If you do palatement by the probe also, you can change the appearance. You can see change in the appearance of the of this incipitated material. Localized duct ectasia with incipitated secretions and negative 4 malignancy. This is another case, 34 years, again with left uniorificial bleeding. This is the ductography. There is no definite filling defects. And here, this is the ultrasound. Note here, this is echogenic secretion casting the duct. And when you do dynamic palatement, you found that these secretions are moving. They are movable secretions. So when you do by the probe compression, you found that secretions are moving. Also, if the secretions are incipitated balls like the last case, they change their size, their position. They can change this their position. So this is a case of localized duct ectasia. Only secretions seen. You hear the duct caliber is uniform. There is no focal dilatation in part as in cases of intraductal masses. This is another case. This is the nipple. And here the duct, localized duct ectasia here. If we stop at that position, we will not see the mass. Here. This is another duct, but shows incipitated secretions also, secretions inside, low-level internal echoes inside. But there is no solid component. Another case. This is also localized duct ectasia, not bilateral and dilated here. And we have to go as lateral as possible in order to be sure that there is no masses at the end of this duct. Another case, 38 years with uniorificial bleeding. And here we have, this is the nipple, and this is dilated ducts. But when you go through this duct, we found here that there is a mass with vascularity inside. Note how we can detect the vascularity. We can detect the vascularity. It's coming from one side. And here, what I told you before, that you have to see the vascularity from many positions. Here is sagittal position, and we can take the axial, and this is the vessel is coming from the posterior wall of the duct. So this was a case of intraductal papilloma. There is a vessel coming, vascular pedicle sign. So this is more with the papilloma rather than the carcinoma. So don't see only the dilated duct, but trace it proximally to the lobules of the breast in order to be sure that there is no mass present. So this is an intraductal papilloma. This is another case. Here the duct is dilated and there is a mass, and this mass is non-dependent. And this is one of the criteria I told you before. If the mass is non-dependent coming from the upper wall, then it is not a secretion, it is a mass. So this is a non-dependent mass coming from the wall of this duct, towards intraductal papillon. This is another mass causing focal dilatation. Again, focal dilatation of the duct with lobulated outline, and it has high vascularity on color Doppler. Increased vascularity with lack of arborization usually make this suspicious for malignancy. So this was an intraductal papilloma with atypia. Another case, although it is faintly seen on ultrasound, but on Doppler there is vascularity inside. So this is another case of intraductal papilloma. Here is a male breast, and this male was coming with breast discharge. And here we have tubular dense structures retroareolar. Can a male get duct ectasia? Yes, because the male has ducts. So this is dilated ducts with thickened periductal mastitis also. It's dilated ducts with periductal mastitis. So it is duct ectasia in males. It can occur in males. So to sum up, ultrasound examination is highly sensitive and specific in diagnosis of intraductal pathology. Color and power Doppler in a specific is sensitive in detecting flow in the intraductal echogenic mass to differentiate it from insipidated secretions. Ultrasonography is useful, not useful, it is diagnostic in these cases rather than mammography. Ultrasound-guided fine needle biopsy is minimally invasive technique in confirming the presence of suspicious intraductal mass. Little work makes a lot of happiness, so please try to reach a good diagnosis, and thank you.